finally introduced the Mandatory Provident Fund in the year 2000. However, Nelson Chao said that under this scheme, low-paid workers will be able to collect only meager sums of money saved on their behalf when they retire. And the scheme itself is no answer to the problems posed by an aging population. With the number of senior citizens increasing, the government spent over $20 billion in 2003 on welfare and medical and other services for the elderly. The sum was as much as 10% of total government spending for the year, a very sizable amount of taxpayers' money indeed, all because of poor government planning. Seven percent of our senior citizens are now living in homes for the elderly, with the government footing most of their expenses. In terms of government spending, this, together with community support services, means an annual outlay of $3.3 billion.
我而家院收嘅老人咧，超過九成係享用緊政府嘅綜援服務咯，每一個平均都有80-50歲㗎，有60-10年左右。婆婆好笑容，婆婆好快樂。佢啲成90歲㗎啦，佢咁佢由於個肺個問題，咁所以佢咧就要用一啲濟氧機，24小時都用住濟氧機㗎。咁我哋其中有4-5個咧就住咗10幾年㗎啦。我諗絕大部分90%到咧就一路住到佢80歲老啦。
In comparison with Singapore and Taiwan, Hong Kong has a significantly larger percentage of its senior citizens living in homes for the elderly. The figure for both Singapore and Taiwan is 4% compared with Hong Kong's 7%.
我外母今年係96歲，祝佢係接受公共援助嘅，入院啊都唔使錢，有政府資助。即係我本身幾年都冇嘢做啦。我外母咧就係需要人照顧嘅，因為啲後生要翻工要揾食，又冇人照顧你留你一個喺屋企咧就比較危險啲，因為佢又跌過受傷，咁佢又冇得聲反對，咁我哋就入嚟。佢申請咗嗰個老人福利嘅，就應該佢個足夠佢而家俾院費。
要處理嘅問題咧，就唔少嘅。要去做嘅時候咧，就一定係要個人、家庭、社會同埋政府咧幾方面去配合都先至得嘅，就唔係話任何一方面做咧就可以處理同埋解決到個問題。
爸爸，有冇氣促啊你？
Hong Kong's population is aging fast. By 2031, 25% of it, that's about 2 million people, will be 65 years of age or older. Meanwhile, there's nothing to suggest we're prepared for the explosion of the elderly sector. Take medical services, for example. At present, senior citizens, who already constitute 12% of the population, occupy 40% of all hospital beds. A serious shortage of hospital beds means elderly patients need to be transferred to a convalescence facility as soon as their doctors pronounce them stable. As the population continues to age, Professor Jean Wu says we can no longer rely on a traditional medical system. Other services must be continuously developed to minimize the frequency of elderly patients being brought to the hospital emergency room or hospitalized. Among the things that must be done are setting up day hospitals, outreach medical services, and convalescence groups. What Professor Wu is saying is that medical professionals should do some serious soul searching and change their attitude towards the elderly accordingly.
有啲醫生啊、學生啊，咁都好對呢方面，佢覺得係好難嘅，唔係咁吸引嘅，即係老人家唔係咁吸引。其實我唔明點解個個唔喺度睇老人科，因為個個都會老噶嘛，屋企。